Las Vegas Aces looking to become only the second team in league history to three-peat. The back-to-back champs, first repeat champions in 21 years. It's year 27 of the WNBA, and we are in the land of the champions. We will hear from Becky Hammond, Asia Wilson, Sydney Colson. All will be mic'd up for practice today. Welcome to Real Training Camp, Las Vegas Aces. Chris Miles here with Angel Gray. You hear the music, you feel the vibe. What are you most excited about for today?
Okay, so we may not condone the lyrics, but I definitely tell you what, we enjoy the energy in the building right now, and it's definitely going to be exciting to see a team that's chasing history once again. You said it in the open, for them to get back-to-back championships for the first time since 2002, since the Sparks were able to do it, going after it again for the three-peat for the first time since the Houston Comets, who took the first four. Now we get to see the core four of the Aces and day one of training camp and what it takes to actually win a championship. What are they doing on the hard floor now? And it's exciting to hear from some of the best talent in the world.
Yeah, you say the core four, the four all-stars that they have on this team. And of course, the news before the season started, Candace Parker, the future Hall of Famer, retiring. So they lose her, but they did draft four players. We're going to get a good look at some of them and to see you also fill out this roster.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's what it comes down to. And what people don't understand is that everyone that is drafted will not be on the final roster. We saw even last season how there was a first-round pick that was not able to make that final roster with Abby Myers. So when you're thinking about De'Asia Fair, a piece that has gone in the second round, the Aces did not have a first-round pick. Three in the second round, one in the third. What are these pieces going to be able to do? Kate Martin is here. We're excited to see De'Asia Fair. How did she stay on the board? Over 3,000 points. She can light it up. I think she reminds me of a player such as Raquana Williams, who used to be on this roster. So there's going to be some players and some room for them to grow as far as depth on this roster. Will we see them working for it today?
Yeah, and we get to see four quarters of it's practice, but it's a scrimmage, and you bet they're going to go hard. And like you just said, look at the players, the decoration, and that's not even getting a half of it. All the awards that they accomplished last year and trying to make history as only the second team in the league to ever three-peat. But you mentioned some of those younger players, some of the new faces we get to see on the floor. Just amazing to see them out here now and going to get an opportunity of real basketball at the professional level.
I think they're ready for it. I think the talent that we saw in the NCAA tournament, the talent that we saw across the landscape of women's basketball, I think they've been battle-tested. The talent has been so good to watch. How does it translate? How does their game style flow within this roster now? So it's going to be interesting to see how they infuse themselves. I was watching a little bit of their behind-the-scenes with their practices already, and it was interesting to see De'Asia Fair talk about the terminology with Becky Hammond, how that's going to be something that she has to grasp, how she understands what she needs to be for this team as well. Candace Parker, when she joined them last season, she said the terminology was something that was frustrating her for a while just to get it right. So will they be able to put themselves in a position that they're learning from the absolute best, the champions? There's a lot of pressure to be in this situation and say, how can we make a roster? But they have to take complete control of it and just have fun too. This is, dreams are coming true right now. We get to cover it, so I'm really excited to see how that unfolds.
As we hear from Becky Hammond when she's mic'd up and she, you know, puts some of that terminology out there, I'm gonna lean on you to break it down for me, because this is a true inside look we're gonna have with the Las Vegas Aces. And Nikki Fargus joins us now, president of this great organization and this great building we're in and this great team we're around. You really are in a great situation, but we have to go back in history a little bit, right? Spent years as a head coach, a last stop at LSU before coming here. Take us through how that experience, right, prepared you for this job and this opportunity when you're trying to evaluate talent and such.
Well, I think as a head coach, you're obviously about the people. It's all about people. It's all about culture. It's all about building a winning and a championship brand. And so to be able to have Becky Hammond as our head coach and what she's been able to do in a short period of time, we're just truly excited that we've got Asia Wilson, Chelsea Gray, Kelsey Plum, Jackie Young. That's been our core nucleus, along with Kia Stokes, and we've been able to add the pieces. So really it's about the players, but also I've got to give a huge shout out to our front office, because they are the team behind the team, and the work that they do to make sure that our arena is sold out, to make sure that we are doing what we need to do in the community, it all blends together in such a positive way.
first time in history selling out, which was amazing when you're thinking about being in this space right now and then setting the bar for other organizations and franchises saying, okay, when is our, you know, new practice facility coming as well? Just really setting the foundation of what it takes to be a pro in the WNBA. But you look at what you guys were able to do last season, winning back-to-back championships. Now moving forward, the focus is what do we need now? Going back to what you were able to see from that roster, going into even what the draft was, what are those needs specifically for you guys?
Well, obviously we talked about the nucleus, but a huge need for us is to continue to build out our bench. We want to make sure that we have depth. And you saw in game four when we were short a couple of our major players that our bench really was the determining factor of us winning our back-to-back championship. So the Sydney Colsons and the Bells, and then obviously we plugged Alicia Clark into the starting lineup along with Kayla George. That's what this training does for you. It allows those players who may not be the star players to, when their number is called, they're going to be ready and they answered the call.
I would be remiss, just because I do have to toss it back to my partner here, but when you're thinking about a piece that is missing in the legendary Candace Parker deciding to retire right before the training camp began, I know that you recruited her to Tennessee and she shared that amazing story with us. But as you're looking at her journey, being able to recruit her out of high school, win championships at Tennessee, and then go on and win three championships on the pro level, if you can just describe and express what she's meant to this game and also just how you've been a part of that.
You know, I remember Candace Parker when she was, well, she was never this high, but I remember when she was coming into her own, and she was 13 years old playing on the AAU circuit. And then to have her at Tennessee and us win back-to-back titles, but Candace Parker, I don't think people really give her enough credit. You know, she is a unicorn in this game. To have a 6'4 player that can play every position, 1 through 5, and she makes everybody around her better. But her true gift is her being so unselfish. Like, she's beautiful, she's smart, she can play this game. And then she's just so humble and gracious when you meet her, and everybody that she meets, they feel like she gives them her undivided attention. And I think the one thing that we wanted to do was bring in players that also knew what it would take to win a championship. And so she's been on that trajectory her entire career. And to have her join us, and you know, I can get a little emotional here because it's a joy that I've been able to witness greatness. I'm sad to see it go right now, but her legacy and what she's meant to this game, no one can ever take that away from her because she's earned it every time she stepped on the floor.
Yeah, one of the greats to ever play the game, Candace Parker. Congrats again, and colleague of ours, of course, on her retirement. But looking forward at this team and the kind of potential future Hall of Famers that you have on this roster, when you're trying to figure out those last couple of spots, right? You have 8 returning players. You go, typically you carry 11. How difficult is it to get down to cutting those final players who all seemingly deserve those spots on the roster?
Yeah, I'm gonna leave that to Becky Hammon and her staff. But no, it's a challenge because I feel like this has been one of our most competitive training camps. Mm-hmm. And these players are coming in here knowing that we've got to display and put on display everything that we can showcase in a short period of time. It's a really short runway for them. And so to know the plays, to pick up the plays, to understand what you have to do when you're coming into training camp, it is difficult to make a roster. And I think that's the one thing that Becky Hammon has created what is in her practice plans, is how can I showcase and allow them to showcase what it is that's going to make them stand out for me as the head coach to decide who I take. But again, so much talent here in our training camp.
Nikki, I'm just going to go back to one word that you used prior. You said family. We want to establish that here within this franchise, and that's something that I know goes back to your days at Tennessee. And it was interesting hearing your story with Candace Parker about the definite dozen.
Yes.
That was established with the great Pat Summitt, but how you use that to push the next generation and starting just with this franchise, what that means and how you use it.
Well, if you haven't heard about the definite dozen, then you should. You should look it up because, you know, at Tennessee, we created a dynasty. And when you're able to have a code. It's like a code of conduct. It really is your compass on what you should do every day. And I still carry the definite dozen with me in everything that I do. But it's not just for you as a basketball player. It's for you as a mom. It's for you as a wife. It's you as a coworker. So, you know, there's 12 principles. Responsible, being honest, being loyal, making hard work your passion, change is a must, handle success just like you handle failure, just like you handle success. These are all life lessons that Pat Summitt taught us. And so we all, there's 161 of us that played for Coach Summitt. And when you go there, you understand what it's going to take, not just to compete for a championship, but also to win a championship.
You know, that's great. I mean, just honoring again the late, great Pat Summitt and looking at Becky Hammon and what she's doing in her first 2 years, which let's just say this and put this on the record. She should have been a head coach well before she got the opportunity, right? But to see what she's done once she's gotten the opportunity and her story as a player, undrafted, coming in like, hey, I'm going to make a roster spot. What does she bring to the table on a daily basis that maybe the rest of us don't see?
Well, undrafted, obviously, you know that she worked her tail off to get into this league, and she was able to do so in such a competitive way, and she just loved the game. She's a student of the game, and you can see that in how she coaches and her style of play, and she's constantly challenging herself and her staff to be better each year. But Becky Hammon is special. I mean, I've been around some great coaches. You mentioned Pat Summitt, Debbie Ryan, Billy Moore, and Becky has that like it factor. You can't really describe it, but you know it's there when you come into the building. And then her ability to just pull the best out of players. I remember Asia Wilson, the first year I got here, Asia wasn't shooting a lot of threes. And then Becky was like, hey, let it fly. And then Asia now has expanded her game where she's not just the player on inside on the post and the go-to player, but you got to guard her on that three-point line as well. And so I think she just gives them a different level of confidence.
We were all witnesses. I mean, I was on the call for that game against Atlanta when she had 53, so historic indeed. And just when you mentioned just all the talent that you have here, you cannot say anything without leading with Asia Wilson.
Yes. Yeah, Asia Wilson is, when she finishes, she will be the best in the world, hands down. And I'm saying it, and I'm going on record, because she plays on both sides of the basketball. There's been some great offensive players that come into this league. But when you have a player that owns the paint, not only scoring it, but defending it, her ability to shot as a shot blocker, her ability to defend and rebound, but more importantly, she's so great in the locker room. And so, and then look what she's doing in the community. You know, I think she's someone that a lot of people look up to. She's addressing some of the issues and things that we are dealing with as a society, and she's doing it unapologetically, and she's doing it with her platform, and that's been such a joy to watch.
Yeah, you mentioned a lot of those things, but I want to go back to what you said in the middle there, right? Because you said definitively.
Yes, I did.
The greatest player to play the game, and I've had this conversation with a lot of people. I'm like, hold on. Has there ever been a player with this much success to start their career, right, in the WNBA? And there's a couple of names there, and I'm like, okay. So what is it that Asia Wilson would have to accomplish to definitively be the best player to ever play in the WNBA?
Continue being Asia Wilson, because the wins, the victories, the championships, they're going to come. She is one of the best leaders on and off the court that I've seen in my college career as a coach and then sitting here now as the president. But Asia Wilson demands excellence, not only from her teammates, but from herself. So she's not going to do anything that she's not going to ask of herself. And I think that's the buy-in, and that's why we're sitting here today as defending two-time world champions because of this young lady. And again, when you look at Asia Wilson, we can talk about what she can do on the offensive end because she is a walking bucket.
Yes.
But what separates her, and this is why I'm calling her the best, is the ability to play on the other side. You don't want to go against Asia Wilson defensively because she's going to guard multiple positions, and then she's going to be there to help and rotate. And I can't say how many, all those shots she's blocking, she's coming out of nowhere. And you're just like, how did she get there? That's what Asia Wilson brings to this game.
One thing before you say anything, I have an agenda today.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
I want my Asia Wilson signature shoe. I said it, Angel, for the first time in this show.
You got to know it's coming. You got to know it's coming. I mean, I think that Asia absolutely deserves it.
Yes.
And I think that she, better than any of us, knows what's going on within her camp. And I think it's great that you can see the uproar, even through social media and through the community, that have her back. And now you do put the pressure on everyone else to say, hey, what are you guys doing? This is deserved. And so I can't wait until that is released, whatever that date may be, whatever that shoe may be like. I'm excited because Asia Wilson is just, I mean, I wanted to bring flowers in this facility today because she deserves every single petal. I'm so excited about what she has already laid out. She has nothing to prove anymore. But I think what was very interesting in the documentary that I was watching with Aces versus Everybody, she said, I am constantly feeling like I have to prove myself. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what makes her great, just understanding that she always has that chip on her shoulder.
Yeah, and that's the driving force when you look at someone who talks about her grandmother not even being able to walk the campuses of the campus of South Carolina. And then here's a statue of Asia Wilson. And so, you know, the thing about Asia too is, again, I say this all the time, like she is so humble. She is so, she plays with gratitude. She lives her life with gratitude. And she understands like her heritage. She understands the struggle and the fight and what she has to do to make life a little bit better, if you can, for the next generation. And she's owning that. And that was, and to me, that's a lot, that takes a lot of courage. But more importantly, it takes a young lady that has a vision, who knows where she's going, not only on the basketball court, but as a businesswoman. She's in commercials. She's an entrepreneur. She's an author. She is showing everybody and showcasing to everybody that I am more than just a uniform. And that's what you get from Asia Wilson.
And you see the success on your screen right now. Conference finals, WNBA champions last 2 years. And there's three number one overall picks on this roster, right? So we've waxed poetically about Asia Wilson. But truly, Jackie Young, Kelsey yes. Plum, seeing the way that they've developed and getting better year over year, you go, wait, Jackie Young's really increased her scoring every single year she's been in the league? How is that even possible? Oh, her three-point percentage is up. What does that tell us about how that group is gelling together as we go year over year?
When you talk about Jackie Young, she's got to be in the conversation for MVP.
Mm. Yeah.
I'm putting that out there, too, because Jackie Young is a dominant player in her ability to play through contact. And then her three ball, it comes off so easy. And I know she'll talk about Tyler Marsh and what he's been able to do in working with her, but she is that player that every single season you can see her getting better. You can see the confidence in her game just elevating. And I think Jackie Young, again, is the silent assassinator, if you will, on our roster. There's a lot of hype and a lot of talk about Asia Wilson and Chelsea Gray and the Candace Parker. And then there's Jackie Young. And to be able to do what she did at Notre Dame, winning a championship there, coming here with two championships, oh my gosh. I mean, she's just touching the surface right now.
I don't know who says silent assassin. I guess it's because she doesn't talk much, but everyone knows it's coming. Yeah. Everyone.
Yeah. The craziest part of just talking to you right now is, like, you sound like a fan, and all that you've accomplished as a player and a coach. Thank you for spending some time with us. Nikki Fargus, the president here at the Las Vegas Aces. It's been a pleasure talking with you. King Champs, the Las Vegas Aces here in Henderson, Nevada. Remember, we're going to see four quarters of full scrimmage basketball with the reigning champs, but right now they're practicing their shooting, and it's a perfect time to listen in to their two-time MVP, their two-time champion, defensive player of the year, Asia Wilson.
Come on, AC, get it like this drill.
Gotta sell it. Good.
Gray on D first.
Jeez. I didn't even say anything.
Okay, so here's what we're doing.
Oh, boy.
Ready? So we're going to do shell 4-on-4. We're going to move it. What I want to see is us jumping to the ball. We are like, I love huggers. I'm a Midwesterner. I'm a hugger. Okay, but do not hug your man. Okay, that ball is away from you. Jump after it's gone around. Here's the other thing. If KB passes it to Megan, you can jump the ball, but I want you to cut, get through, pull. Let's start getting some movement behind the shell. Okay, so it's either pinned down, it's cut through, whatever it might be. Okay, as soon as you hear Tyler yell beat, we're live. We're playing to 5 stops. You can only score on defense.
Okay.
If you get a stop, you stay on?
Yes, ma'am. If, yeah, go ahead, give him the butt, Celia. Give him the butt.
If you give him an offensive rebound, you still continue that play, but and if it ends in a, you get a defensive rebound, whatever, you're just off still, and you don't get a point.
You want to stay on defense as long as you possibly can. Because if you don't finish it, if it's a miss or a make, but if they miss it and they get it back, then it's going to be -2. Because that's 2 offensive rebounds. It's a -1 for an offensive rebound, a -1. So it could be -2, -3 on one possession if you don't board. Yeah. You don't want them to get O-board, so you need to either get a stop or they score and you're off. The whole point is don't give up any offensive boards.
Okay, so
ready? Yeah. Here, I got corner here.
Phil!
Coming out.
Chip!
Coming through.
Chip!
Go in. You good, KB? Get that rear!
Now here. We're live!
By yourself! By yourself! By yourself!
I found
it. One for Gray! One for Gray! You know what? Let's stop the movement because there's too much movement. By the time he yells beat, we might be cutting. So let's just go ding, ding, ding around, shift, close, and then on the beat, you're live.
Okay. Here. Skip it here, me, here. Gap it.
Shift.
2-9, 2-9. Get there. Oh, yeah.
I don't think he can get beat.
Like, faster.
I know he's saying faster, beat, but I'm not trying to overhelp.
Faster.
Get in front. Yeah. It's live after that.
Hold up. It's same team on. Same team on because it went out of bounds. Okay, here we go.
You're good.
On D. Nothing hurt.
Here, I'm here. I'm here. Skip it.
Stop, hold up.
I don't want to get beat.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to get beat, though.
I know, but just for the drill because we need to work on the rotations. I know you're going to guard your man. There's 0 doubts about
that.
All
right, then
we beat. Okay? But we got to work on this top one. And her going and her dropping. That's okay. What we're working on.
My bad.
I know. I like it.
2-9, 2-9, 2-9. Here, by yourself. 2-9, 2-9. Here, come on. Get out. I'll just stay out there.
Woo!
What a whistle.
Off, that's a foul.
Oh, okay.
I'm reffing right here. Here we go.
Yeah. No middle.
Angel can't go there.
No middle.
Go again, Green. Can't go there.
Yep.
Good, how you doing?
Get there. Oh, yeah, come on with it.
Keep playing. Play.
It's live. Come up with it.
Oh, boy. Keep playing.
That's what she does.
Yeah, man. Black on D.
Yeah.
That first baseline person, let him go.
We're stopping, yeah.
Yeah. Like Megan cut her off that time.
Yeah,
Megan let her go.
I was like, I can't go nowhere. You're good. Two nine. By yourself. Two nine. Here. Gap it. Beat.
Draw.
Lead the trap.
Good. Oh. Two for great.
You know, once you lead the trap, you're going up middle and find it.
Wax on. Block that. Black, that shouldn't happen, Black.
Gap it. Two nine. I'm over. Oh, shit.
Good cut. Good cut. Blacks on D. All right. Blacks on D. Good cut.
Got you. I don't think that's an open. Yeah.
No, UKB!
Way to scramble!
Good stop. KB, you know that was you, right? Okay.
Go for it, bro. Yeah, no help side. D, talk so she can know you're there. Louder.
Drop KB! That's you. Hey, this is the one stickler thing that keeps biting. I'm beat right here. You got to see both of them.
Yeah.
And I would suggest this. So here comes the ball. Like, this probably isn't going to get it done. You're going to have to sprint to this pop because they're sprinting down your ass. Get down there. See both.
With four people.
You might have to take it.
Low eye, yeah.
And she goes. If you, at the end of it, go back. Let's see. Go ahead. Here's the beat. She comes across, right? And right here, Bria. Right here. You need to see both these players. Okay? Because what's happening is they're cutting here. To that regard, you got to see that. If you don't see it,
low eye, yeah.
This low person, we don't want to give up layups. Okay? That is not protecting Vegas. But if you have, you know, it's not going to be perfect every time. Keep playing and back each other up and pick each other up and cover for each other.
There, 2-9, skip it. Here, beat, corner, can't help.
Come on. Good. It's all right. Yep. Good shot, K-Mac. Or AC, yes, hard sir. Rotation. Remember, you got another one in there in a real game. It's five of you.
Yeah. Middle, now. Come up with it. Oh, my God. Green.
That's two old boards. I don't know if anybody's noticed. Megan goes to the board every time with aggression. You might want to find her.
Don't even let her shake.
Good play.
Nice, Kiki.
And one. Here we go. Servers on D. Here we go.
2-9. Here, I got ball. Here. Gap it. 2-9. I'm here. Give it in. Go up. If you don't go.
Check up.
Yeah. 2-9. Here, skipping it. Corner, no help. No middle. Bria. Shots up. Oh, come on, with it.
Can't go there, Bree.
Yes.
Can't go, Bria.
No middle. We on.
Here we go.
We on. We still on D. Two nine. Here.
Drop.
Here. Got it. Yeah, that's a turnover.
Wait a minute. Who fouled? Oh, yeah, but it was on the floor.
I got you.
It's on the floor. A shooting foul, we're going next time. Is the difference between, like, I don't mind some off-ball fouls on physicality. But, like, shooting fouls, like, we're going to get on. That's just giving the other team free throws. Here we go.
Here, skipping it. Here.
Chip.
Nail. Here, I'm here. Shot. You.
Here we go.
Yeah. That's a long two. Get something better.
Here we go. Next girl.
Oh, shit. You're good. Here.
Chip.
Here. Got your 2-9. Here. No corner help.
Play. Hold up. No. So, KP, that was a slot drive. So there's only one of you on that backside. But as soon as she takes the first one, somebody else has to go and rotate to the next one. Now, at the end of the day, look, KP, Jack, those ones that are like super fast and can shoot.
Pick your poison.
Yeah, like, I mean, what I'm saying is it's really hard. That's the toughest closeout in basketball, guarding a three-level scorer. Yeah. That can go either direction, shoot threes, and finish, okay? You guys are all be a pain.
Yeah. And it's
supposed
both
to be y'all. Disadvantage. What are you going to give me? The three, or are you going to give me the drive? You're fine. And don't forget you have another player on there for rotations. This is way a little bit easier in the game, okay? Yup. Drop, Jack. Good.
Okay, Jack.
Oh, hold up. Green ball. No, that's not a stop.
Becky Hammon looking to coach the stingiest defense you've ever seen. Funniest part of that was Asia Wilson saying, welcome back to Real Training Camp here from Henderson, Nevada. Representing the Las Vegas Aces as they get ready for the season, which starts on May 14th. We're joined by Jennifer Azey, a Women's Basketball Hall of Famer, fifth pick in the draft. Way back when.
A couple of years ago.
But now, I got to get your current title together because it's Chief Business Development Officer.
I'm yes. Like,
okay, so we're going to talk business and basketball a little bit later. In the business of the Aces, it's booming. I mean, the fact that you sold out season tickets back in March, high demand to see this great basketball team. Makes your job a little bit easier, huh?
Makes my job a lot easier, especially when, you know, you're able to build a business around the incredible young women on the court, and they are the best at what they do. And, you know, a lot of this is a credit to Mark Davis and, you know, just the philosophy in buying the team was investment. So this beautiful headquarters, the greatest players in the world, you can't really go wrong, and we've definitely invested in the community here as well.
Can we talk about the headquarters just a little bit, just how they're able to? We didn't get the full tour. I didn't get the full tour, at least. But when you walk in here, there's a sense of just excellence, like no detail was left out just from our route. Establishing that, what that took, and just the buy-in from the community with this group, how does that all fall into place?
Well, I'll tell you, as a former player being in this role, it's exciting to come here to work every day. So, you know, I walk in this building, I don't take a minute of this for granted, and I know that our players understand that this is an elevated experience here in Las Vegas. I mean, we have the best of everything. If you're not ready to go as a player here, you have access to everything, and it is, you hit the nail on the head that it's all about excellence. And we're striving for excellence in everything we do. And, you know, Nikki Fargus as our president, Matt Delson as our CFO, did a great job in assembling the team behind the team. So I sort of look at it like winners attract one another, both on and off the court.
Can you explain to the viewers what this community is like when you have, of course, the sellout of season tickets? That's one thing. They show up, they show out. But they are very notable. We're seeing, like, full posters on, you know, casinos. And we, yeah. I mean, you can see each player that's represented within this city. Just talk about the energy behind this W team.
Well, there's incredible energy, and again, it goes back to the best product on the court. So it starts with that, and then it starts with the investment that Mark has made and, you know, creating, I think, a really fantastic leadership team. And then, you know, I give a lot of credit to Blair Hardick, who's now our chief strategy officer, was our chief marketing officer for, you know, sort of the city takeover, even during WNBA All-Star and then during the parade at the final. I mean, it's incredible, both, you know, kind of the efforts on the business side, but then also just the community embracing us and the local businesses embracing us.
The parade, I'm pretty sure, was amazing. Can you talk about being a part of that for back-to-back seasons?
You know, it was incredible. In the first year that we had the parade, we had planned on shutting down half of the strip. And we kept saying all year, shut down the strip, shut down the strip. And, you know, we were the first major sports championship here. And so we were going from Caesars to Bellagio, essentially. Well, they had to shut down the other side of this trip because there were so many people that were coming to, you know, support us. And it's like the city has just come alive with the Golden Knights, the Raiders, and us. And what I love as a woman is we're in the conversation with all those sports. It's not just, oh, we're the women's team. It's we are another professional team here in Las Vegas, and it's exciting.
Tell us about the Alumni Initiative and how it's unique to this organization and exactly what it is.
Well, the Alumni Initiative, in all honesty, is what got me here. It got Becky Hammon here, and it got Natalie Williams here. So we all independently came for an alumni weekend when Nikki started as president and Mark Davis had bought the team. And it's, you know, in line with the Raiders. Once a Raider, always a Raider. Once an ace, always an ace. And so I was so impressed with what was going on here, you know, and then having the opportunity to really kind of jump in here and really do this. It was a result of the alumni initiative. And so, you know, every year now we've had an alumni weekend where we've had, you know, 50 to 70 alums coming in, and it's, you know, all expenses paid to come to Las Vegas, support the Aces, and really be a part of this community, because there's no better ambassadors for what we're doing than our alums.
It kind of helps to be in Vegas.
I think it does. You know,
you guys want to come spend a weekend.
Not a bad gig.
Exactly.
I think it was very special, too, obviously, with the Silver Stars coming back. Then Becky Hammon, her jersey's retired.
Yes.
Then you announce, hey, she's also going to be the head coach. Success very early on. Mm-hmm. It's great to see her trajectory and just her journey throughout the head coach. Just coming back to the W, right?
Yeah.
But when you're thinking about her story, but also how you, as a former WNBA player, found a different route to impact, you know, the next generation, what does that feel like for you?
You know, it's awesome. I mean, to have the opportunity to develop the business side of the sport, that's what I'm attracted to. I love generating revenue. For me, revenue is the game. You know, I you know, we've got the best on the court, and so I think to take the WNBA into women's sports into the next, you know, the next phase is revenue generation and showing a profitability behind the scenes. Because if not, it's great to watch, but then, you know, are we elevating? Are we, you know, we're blessed here because Mark gave us, you know, everything that we need to be successful. So now, how can we then generate revenue?
You know, as a former player, take us through your journey to get into this role, because a lot of times when you're done with basketball, it's always like, okay, you're going to be a coach, you're going to get into the media, right? But then this role, it's so different. Take us through your journey and how you got it.
Well, you know, this role is very different for a former player, and sometimes I have to battle that I was a former player. But in reality, I think the best people in roles like mine are former players, because you have a different why in why you do this. And so for me to elevate the game and take it to the next level, now that I have the business knowledge and the playing background, so I've got a passion for it that I think, you know, rivals anyone. So it's an exciting place to be, and I get to use sort of the best of my life experiences being in this role. But I also spent 5 years in development. So I was an associate vice president at the University of San Francisco after my coaching career. So I gained a skill set that has really helped me in my role.
Win percentage on a screen before coming to Vegas, and then win percentage since coming to Vegas, and I guess wins stay in Vegas, right? They say what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, all wins all the time.
Absolutely. You know, it's interesting as I look at that too. I played in San Antonio and played in Utah. So hopefully I'm part of that 41
For sure.
point. But, you know, and there were some really good years in some of those franchises, but again, it wasn't until having an owner that wanted the team. You know, in the beginning of the WNBA, I think when David Stern and, you know, some of the Rick Wells, Gary Stevenson, some of the group, Val Ackerman, that, you know, were sort of the original brains behind the WNBA, I think there was really good intent in this. And maybe David Stern saw this down the road, but you've got to have partners in owners. And so, yeah, I think Mark Davis is the perfect owner. And I think in the early franchises, maybe the Stars and some of the others, you know, you question, did the owners really want the franchise? And now we're in a situation where owners want the franchise. And, you know, you see it now with the Warriors owning a team and Joe Lacob. And so it's an exciting time to, you know, to take this to the next level.
Maybe Serena Williams, maybe Beyonce. We don't know. Hey, maybe, you know, who knows who's going to be in the building owning a team at this point. But I want to say something for my last question. You talked about the investment in women in the sport, just being a part of it then and seeing the growth now.
Yeah.
What's the most impressive thing to you?
You know, I think that social media has done a lot for us. You know, there's good and bad, right, with social media. But we've been able to have a different kind of exposure and go, you know, players have been able to speak directly to fans. And so we've had some incredible personalities and, you know, Asia Wilson, Kelsey Plum, I mean, Candace Parker, you know, that have these followings. And so I think that's been huge for us. I think the increased exposure in the NCAA is certainly helping the WNBA. So it's kind of the perfect storm where and I just come back to the product on the court. It's always been good, but it's outstanding. And so when you have that, and then you've got the media, social media, you know, it's just on such an upward trajectory.
Jennifer Azy, we are out of time, but I'm telling everybody this. We got to get Asia Wilson that signature shoe. You're on the side. I don't know if you have anything to do with that, but that is the theme of the day, Asia Wilson getting her signature shoe.
Well, look, I'm all about it. I don't work for Nike, but, you know, I certainly would love to see that happen. There's no one more deserving.
Just
waiting for the day to come.
Just do it.
Those watching Real Training Camp, you know that will continue to be the theme. The three-peat is what they're searching for the Las Vegas Aces, your back-to-back reigning champs in the WNBA. Here we are at Real Training Camp. Chris Miles here with Angel Gray. And we're fully mic'd up. Angel, this is a great opportunity to look at both ends of the floor.
The continuous three-on-three drill. I know that everybody that has been in their shoes probably doesn't like this drill too much because it's absolutely challenging you on the defensive end. It's not anything for the defensive end to score. You can only get points if you get those stops, so it's very important for Becky Hammon. She's been very vocal about how this team needs to be defensively. We saw that in the Aces versus Everybody documentary that was spectacular, that was released just a couple of days ago. But that's because she has some amazing offense that's added onto it. Through the first five games, they scored 92 points or more. 12 100-point games for this group. Defense is what she thinks is the most important priority at this point.
Your angle right here. Yes. So
this is what you do. Literally.
We want this contact. But we want this contact here to send her this way. You sent her to the middle. Understand?
A teaching moment there from Becky Hammon trying to explain her defensive principles.
And to a rookie as well, De'Asia Fair has been, you know, remarkable on the collegiate level, third in scoring. And I think that one thing she's always said is, like, I want to be a better defender. And I think Becky Hammon, that's one of the best players and minds and coaches that you can learn from. So it will be interesting to see how she continues to challenge her, but also embracing how she gets better for a championship franchise.
For those just tuning in, the practice session that's happening right now, we will see a full scrimmage with the Las Vegas Aces. They're going to play four quarters here on Real Training Camp.
I got you. Yeah. Come in.
Chris, I think that's something that also should be mentioned. Asia Wilson just isn't vocal right now on the defensive end because she knows that she's mic'd up. If you know her, you know that that is what this team needs. That's why she's a leader on this team. She is constantly talking. We had a whole session at the beginning of this show where we were just listening in on the defensive end and how she was getting stops, not wanting to get beat baseline, but that's what the drill called for. But it was no moment of silence within this group. And when you mention just the core four, what that is established with, I mean, it starts with the communication and why they're on the same page, why they are so connected. Because if there is silence, there is a problem within this group.
But that's the rotation. Yes, that's the rotation, Kay.
And there, Asia Wilson explaining the rotation to what they are trying to do defensively and the principles of this team.
I've been cussing him out, so he's going to give me a little something. Step up, step up. Get it. Ooh. That's who we're about to bang.
We won't cut that one for the highlight for Asia.
Oh!
We saw it at Iowa, but just to see how Kate Martin has been able to just get connected with Asia Wilson too, seeing how she's really threading the needle to get her the ball in these situations. Yes, there will be two other defenders on the floor, but I love seeing how rookies can connect with the vets as well, building that trust early in training camp.
Kate Martin, of course, teammates with Caitlin Clark at Iowa.
I love the story. She actually went to the draft to support Caitlin Clark as she went number one overall to the Indiana Fever, but there was a moment where, you know, there were a couple of people saying, wait a minute, she might actually get drafted. And so she was in the bag, heard her name, came back. The team was also with her, and it was really special for Caitlin Clark to enjoy that moment with her as well.
Yeah, you go from Caitlin Clark to Asia Wilson. Not bad, not bad teammates to have.
Dean, you're getting taken down in that post.
For those Aces
KP,
fans.
What should she do? You got to get around. You're getting buried. Like, your head is under the rim. That's not good for you. Get around, get around, get around, get around. But it's yeah, pressure the ball would help her. But you're getting buried too deep. You got to fight them initially, try to push them out. Like, you're going to have to be a little physical. And let's do four. 4 minute game here. 4 minute game.
Let's take a look at the Aces' first 10 games of the season. Again, their opener against the Mercury on May 14th. That is when the banner will be raised. That is where they will get their championship rings. From there, the Mercury again, the Fever, May 25th. That's certainly a date that you want to have circled on the calendar.
I think every franchise has that one circled on the calendar for sure. We were able to see just some early action from the Stars and a few of the draft picks coming in the first round. It's been fun to watch them blossom in this league.
I'm circling that at Atlanta Dream Game. Remember last year, you called that game in which Asia Wilson dropped a WNBA record 53 points. I tried to correct you. I was like, no, she had 54. I was
53.
Sitting there too.
I think tied it as well. Tied, so yeah. It was interesting because all of them being Aces players.
Left. Yo, if you have to call.
So Liz Cambage had that record. That was tied. She actually broke it from Raquana Williams. Did that before she came over to LA.
What we've seen from practice today is as it's come along, you can feel the energy picking up as they get ready for the scrimmage.
Well, the officials have their whistles out. I think everybody looks pretty official to this point, but I think that's when you really get to see up and down how this is actually implemented. Like, what have you learned from the drills that we have done? And everything is very intentional with Becky Hammon. We've already talked about her terminology and how she needs people to understand where she is coming from and how she does her schemes. But I think it's very helpful when you have such a solid group of veterans that can walk the younger crew through what that means and just following by example, because if you don't understand it, at least you can learn from being someone in front of you, leading you by example. So it's been It's been fun so far just to watch how everything has been laid out for Becky Hammon, and we have not seen a lot of offensive drills. We saw one opening three-point shooting drill for everyone to be involved with, and that was it.
To a point that you made earlier, there's been a lot of work of Asia Wilson and Kate Martin together. That seems like that's all on purpose.
I would hope so, because she's a phenomenal passer. I mean, she's been, you already talked about her playing alongside, you know, Caitlin Clark, but also just understanding the game. I think just a high IQ player that understands the when and where. If you have the ball in your hands as a professional, you want to make sure that assist to turnover ratio is in your favor. And for Becky Hammon, that understands what that is also needing to be. She gets it from not just Becky Hammon, but Asia Wilson, who is going to set her up in the best possibilities to get her the ball. And I don't think it hurts, too, that, you know, Chelsea Gray also elevated Asia Wilson and how she needed to be ready for every pass available.
As Asia Wilson knocks that down. You mentioned Chelsea Gray not practicing much today. We know she's coming off of that injury from the WNBA Finals. We checked in with the PR team here. She's good to go.
Yeah.
They're just making sure that she's protected.
You know what's funny, too, with Chelsea Gray? She's not practicing right now, but right now I just glanced over and she's drawing on the board that they have in the huddles. She is a absolute coach, and if you saw anything and took anything away from that game where she couldn't play in game four due to that foot injury, she was the extended coach for this team. She was the heartbeat for them as well, and it's something to just really exciting to see how she's just continued to elevate this group. But I've been able to call games with her, and it's really fun to see how she picks up on plays, how to pick people apart, and I'm really excited to see what that looks like this season.
Yeah, Chelsea Gray, three-time champion. Two with here with the Aces, one with the Sparks back in 2016. She's good on a broadcast, too.
She's all right. She's okay. You know, there, that's the only time when I can be her point guard. So it's a lot of fun being in that way. We got a little a Gray collab in the booth, but it's fun. I know that she has learned a lot throughout her season, you know, in her journey within the WNBA, but it was really special to see her get her first one, especially with Candace Parker and with the Sparks.
Some bumps and bruises through this drill. Looks like Kate Martin a little shook up.
And she took a fall earlier in this practice. It was okay to get up. And also, Kamaria McDaniel as well on the other end, the rookie and guard out of Michigan State. Being tended to on the sideline as well. This is a very physical training camp, and I can't express enough that even for those that get drafted, this is a battle. There are two spots that are available for this team at this point, and it's been interesting to see how everyone is going to apply what they know, what they do best, and try and make this roster. Bria Hartley to a training camp roster coming in as well, and just another veteran who has battled through injuries, seeing her back, has played on a few different franchises. But just to see how she continues to use her voice with this group now, how valuable will that be for Becky Hammon to make a roster?
Like, he just called the shit. He not called the shit. Then he just called a random shit.
And then they called the foul. And then it's like, that's not going to shoot much.
We're done with 300. They're dropping like fucking flies.
Becky Hammon trying to help us out, letting the players know that Asia Wilson is mic'd up.
All right, let's get to those 5-on-5 teams. Here we go.
Is that a punt?
This is what we came. I think that. I don't know. You know, knowing Becky Hammon, I'm pretty sure it was right up the middle. I think another player that you want to keep your eye out on, just a two-year contract that was given to Megan Gustafson out of Iowa as well, was the Big Ten Player of the Year. It came out drafted in the second round, was drafted to the Dallas Wings, was cut from that team, before training camp, but then brought back to the team. So just an understanding of some of your favorite players may not make the roster, but to see her come back in an opportunity year, spend some time with the Phoenix Mercury, backing up Brittany Griner last season, really excited to see what her style is going to look like with this group needing the depth.
Angel, your biggest takeaway?
I think that this is a team that is still very, very good. I know that it got a little chippy out here. Training camp is very tough, but what we're able to see them getting up and down. The offense has not fallen off. They add some really key pieces, and I think it's going to be tough to make this roster, but I'm really excited to see, you know, what they continue to do. The rookies with Kay Martin, Angel Jackson, what is she going to be able to do? De'Asia Fair, how does she make her presence known offensively? Because they need that stretch three off the bench. So it's going to be fun to watch what this group can actually do after training camp.